I just wanted to do this quick video before I watch Funny Farm. And I want to do this. Here's my supper, by the way. Get a glimpse of it. Got two slabs of bologna on each sandwich. Mustard on one, mayo on the other, and mayo on an everything bagel with bologna. It's actually pickle loaf. It's bologna, but it's pickle loaf bologna. That's my supper tonight. I'm going to wait till later and eat that, scarf that down later after I drink. I want to touch on a topic really quick before I move forward with my evening. It's going on 9:30 p.m. Standard Eastern Time. What do you guys think about the RFID chip? I know you guys, I know, like, I read an article on Yahoo. Some people volunteer to get it, but I think eventually a lot of people say it's a sign of the mark of the beast. I was reading an article earlier and based out of Wisconsin. A lot of you guys are already aware that I have a fetish. Milwaukee fetish. Has to do with the nasty fetish beer and then the hot chick. But I would love, it would turn me on sexually to get RFID. Especially if a hot chick implanted it in me. And then, you know, knowing that I'm somebody's bitch, you know, and, you know, I'm at mercy to somebody, because I love when chicks are, like, oh, it's kind of a deep subject. I love a chick in charge. I've been submissive my whole life. I would let a female hog tie me up. I'd let a woman trample me. I'd let a woman spit on me. I don't give a shit. If she's hot, if she's sexy, fucking, you know, I hear stories, there's guys that say, you know, hot chicks. I hear stories, and I never experience it, but I hear stories, and sometimes I hear guys say, just sexy, pretty females stink, and they smell bad. I find that hard to believe. I mean, what I find to be attractive might be different than what he finds to be attractive, and yada, vice versa, yada, yada. But yeah, I get an RFID chip. A lot of people with confident pride, dignity say no, they would never do that, but maybe I don't have pride, self-dignity, and no passion for nothing. I don't know. Later. I guess it's a sign of the times we're living in.